AI is completely changing the world, it's revolutionizing it. And in my case, it will be for microscopy. So all the developments that have been done in computer vision, which is basically you have a digital image and you need the computer to understand what is in that image, that's now being applied to microscopy.
The ambition of our science now is just so different than what it was 3-4 years ago, because we can test research questions at such a scale that were previously unimaginable. So Shigella is a very important human pathogen. It's responsible for hundreds of millions of illness episodes per year, hundreds of thousands of deaths, particularly in children under 5. I think it's also worth noting that Shigella is crucially important in terms of developing antimicrobial resistance. So it's on the top 12 priority pathogens for the World Health Organization, and there's no effective vaccine, so we need to come up with new and creative ways to control Shigella infection. We discovered many years ago how a specific protein in cell called the septin cytoskeleton can recognize invading Shigella cells. And what's really special is upon recognition, they form these cage-like structures, so it keeps bacteria in place. It can't move from cell to cell, it can't disseminate, and in that way the infection is localized. So that's one way in which it's antibacterial. Two, we have shown that once it's compartmentalized bacteria, it's targeted to a process called autophagy. So what it does is it's like garbage disposal inside the cell. So it really is a death sentence for the bacteria to be recognized by these septin cage-like structures. And that's what we want to exploit in order to control Shigella infection. And so we're now lucky we've got microscopes fast enough to visualize both the recruitment and the assembly process around the bacterial cells.
So now we have an automated microscope that has super resolution capacity. It means that you don't really have to be physically at the microscope to acquire the images, which increases the amount of data that you can acquire because it will be running overnight, it will be running over the weekend. These individual yellow crosses will signal where images are going to be acquired. So over the span of a few days, we'll have hundreds of thousands of images that are going to be acquired. And then this data will have to be processed to clean noise, to do other sort of operations. And finally, we'll have the AI part, where we will have the automatic recognition of the bacteria and the discrimination of which ones are entrapping cages and which ones are not entrapping cages. So now we can also test a huge amount of conditions. We can now open the door to do screening campaigns, either with drugs or genetic screens, and therefore in each of these individual wells, it can have a different condition and test, for example, for factors that will increase or decrease septin cage formation, and do this in an automated manner, which will require otherwise like an insane amount of hours of somebody doing this manually. Okay,
for me, this represents future cellular microbiology. Let's have AI tell us what's going on. And once we can understand how we can manipulate the septin caging process, we then have something quite druggable, and we can then target that process to, say, enhance the ability of septins to recognize bacteria X. And in that way, you have a new way of controlling infection. You know, Shigella septin interactions is our model because that's what we've discovered. But we hope to inspire the field where they can use their pathogen of interest or their host pathway of interest and really use our same approaches.